पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशव सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने मूर्ते नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्व वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तहुम हदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वेन अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेवान्नमत्वन्निति। So we are looking at the fifth chapter, Panchakosha Viveka, wherein, I think last we saw what Panchakosha Viveka Prakara. We looked at the Tippana, how the Munja grass, in the case of the Munja, the stem has to be separated carefully. Similarly, the Atma has to be separated cognitively from the five koshas. So that was said in, and Munja was explained in the Tippana, the grass. And then this Vyapaka Tattva, which is Chaitanya, and in comparison, what is this Anatma? So Tasma Dehatrayam, Dehatraya, Panchakosha or Anatma is Avyapakam and Anityam. Whereas Atma, Pratyagatma is Sarvavasthasu Anugatataya Bhati. The Satta and Spurti, which is seen in any Anatma, is also the Atma Prakash and Atma Satta. Atma Satta and Atma Prakasha, Atma Spuranam. Thereby Atma is what? Atma is Vyapaka, Anatma is Avyapaka. And Atma is Nitya, Anatma is Anitya. So Tasmad Vyapako Nityascha Atma. Itham Dehatre Vilakshanataya Vivichya Atmanam Vivichya Atmanam Janiyat. One should know this Atma as separate from the three Dehas, whether at the Vyashti level or Samashti level. So if you know that the Atma is separate from the Panchakoshas or Shariratraya, and even Avastatraya Sakshi at Vyashti and Samashti level, then there cannot be a second at all. So Aikya is established of this Atma. Tatra Stula Shariram Annamaya Koshaha Karana Shariram Anandamaya Koshaha. So what is the mapping of the Pancha Koshas with the Shariratraya? Annamaya Kosha is Stula Sharira. Anandamaya Kosha is Karana Sharira, and the other three Koshas are the Sukshma Sharira. So Sukshma Sharire Pranamaya Manomaya Vijnanamayakhyaha Trayaha Koshaha Antarabhutaha. The middle three Koshas are Sukshma Sharira, they belong to Sukshma Sharira, whereas the Annamaya and Anandamaya belong to the Stula and the Karana Sharira. Tasmat Shariratraya Vivekena Panchakosha Viveko Jayate. Whatever you are comfortable with, Shariratraya is easier to understand. Koshas may be difficult to understand for some. And vice versa, because when you are looking at Koshas, there is more granularity. And especially in the Sukshma Sharira, seeing divisions by functionality may be a little tricky for some. So Shariratraya Viveka is also fine. Thereby Shariratraya Vivekena Panchakosha Viveko Jayate. if sharira traya viveka is simple, even if you do that, you will have done panchakosha viveka as well. Yatha panchakosha vilakshana jiva swarupam tatha eva ishvara swarupam api samashti panchakosha vilakshanam asti. So at the vyashti level also panchakosha viveka, sharira traya viveka is possible, and at the samashti level also both panchakosha and sharira traya viveka is possible exactly in the same manner. Now prakriya wise there are differences, as in where do you start the analysis from, or where do you merge in vyashti and samashti, whether you merge the vyashti sharira in the samashti sharira or the samashti sharira in the vyashti sharira. There is prakriya bheda, but there is no difference in the conclusion. Conclusion is the same. One may be easier for some, the other may be easier for others. For example, Chaitirya Upanishad talks about panchakosha viveka in detail. Sharira trayas are also identified in the bhashya at least. And when you look at the adhyaropa which is done in the creation story, srishti prakriya, the srishti section of that, srishti prakarana, when an explanation is given as tasmadva etasmad atmanaha akasha sambhuta and so on, there if you do the textual mimamsa is on the text anyway, so when you are looking at the text literally, then tasmad va etasmad, why is why there, why is not or, why is indeed, so sandhi, due to sandhi there is yakara lopa after sandhi takes place, so why becomes va, which is why actually, so why indeed tasmad va etasmad means why, tasmad why etasmad, there you look at tasmat and etasmat, tat and etat shabda, they are in samanadikaranyam. And what is tat, what is etat? We know that durastha is tat. And which is very nearby is etat, is identified by etat, represented by the pronoun etat. Now tat pada and etat pada, not padartha, pada, if you analyze, then this tat pada is a pronoun for which noun which has gone by. It is not immediate. It has to be a little earlier because etat is also there. So etat identifies that which is going on in the current mantra. And tat which is there in the earlier lakshana vakya. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. So that satyam jnanam anantam brahma is the tat pada artha there. Tat pada, their tat and satyam jnanam anantam brahma are in samanadikaranyam, meaning tat as a sarvanama is denoting the brahma nama which has gone by in satyam jnanam anantam brahma. So tat is further earlier, it has come by earlier, much earlier in the valli, taitriya valli. So in the Shikshavalli, Satchidananda Brahma or Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, the definition, Lakshana Vakya, the mantra, which is elaborated later, there in the elaboration what was said, that is the Karana, Jagat Karana. So the Lakshana Brahma of we being Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, that Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma is the tat which is etat jagat karanam. That is what the literal meaning is there. But if you analyze further and deeper, etat is, it is also a mahavakya by saying that tad brahma padartha, when you look at padartha, tad brahma which is said as jagat karana, jagat karana is not near, jagat karana is considered as far away. So tad brahma is etat, and then by etat is what? Eshaha Atma. So you do linga parivartana by Videha Pradhanya. So Videha Pradhanyena Eshaha Atma. सो तद ब्रह्मा एषा आत्मा भवति अस्ति देयर बाय यू नो दी ऐक्य आल्सो सो वॉट एवर सृष्टि हैज टेकन प्लेस फ्रॉम दैट ब्रह्म व्हाट सो तस्माद् वा एतस्माद् वै एतस्माद् इफ यू टेक तस्माद् देन फ्रॉम दैट जगत कारण ब्रह्म और फ्रॉम दिस आत्मा विच आई एम एतस्माद् वै सो वन इज ऐक्य एंड देन इट हेल्प्स यू डू पंचकोश विवेक आल्सो एट व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि लेवल बोथ लेवल्स हाउ सो इज when you are doing the viveka and landing from the annamaya kosha to the pratyangatma in 5 steps that time 5 or more steps if you look at more and more granularity even within the functionary buddhi or ahankara there can be more no layerings also possible because there are more functions maybe this function belongs to this particular entity you identified as not yourself but the other functionary seems to be your own then you have to consider that as another kosha which is not an issue so 5 koshas you can based on the granularity you can do more neti neti not this I am not this I am even within more within because without these identifications with any of these I still remain and my satta and spurti is without any dependency on others now this is at the vyashti level at the samashti level when you are doing the viveka at whichever kosha level at the same time you can do the viveka at the samashti level also because tasmad vai etasmad whether you take tat or etat तद ब्रह्म और एष आत्मा मीनिंग तस्माद् ब्रह्मणः और एतस्माद् आत्मनः एवरीथिंग इज बॉर्न एंड देन यू आर डूइंग पंचकोश विवेक दैट टाइम यू विल टू लैंड ऑन दैट जगत कारण ब्रह्म विच इज आत्मा सो यू कैन डू ईदर And while doing the viveka at the vyashti level, if you see that everything else, annamaya, for example, annamaya kosha is pancha mahabhuta karya. What is the difference between pancha mahabhuta karya at the vyashti level and samashti level? Samashti is just a sum up of the annamaya koshas, as many annamaya koshas that we can cognize any which way. In any prani, any devata, any rakshasa, any manushya, across genders, across species, across lokas, including the lokas, sentience is not at the annamaya kosha level. So, sentient or insentient beings have the sharira. Insentient has only sharira, meaning it is just the body, a celestial body we say. Has no association with chetana at least in the modern world if you look at the if you look at celestial body if you say sun mass of gas or whatever they talk about but then surya devata in shastras but surya devata is also an abhimani devata who gives the sentience to the Surya Sharira as though. But if you look at the Annamaya Kosha as just the body which is insentient, when you see that it is insentient, you take away the sentience which is lent, there is no difference at Vyashti and Samashti. There is no difference between a sentient living being's body, Annamaya Kosha, versus this earth or You look at anything which is non-living, a stone, a hill, a table, and so on. So all of these fall together in one category of annamaya. And all these put together become the sharira of Ishvara, Virat Purusha. Therefore, there is no difference between annamaya kosha at the samashti and vyashti level except for the quantity sum total versus a part. So part and whole relation is no relation per se. We are not looking at relation, but if you look at the relation, then you can resolve the annamaya kosha at the vyashti level into samashti cognitively. We know that it is a part and whole relation, so you resolve the annamaya kosha at the vyashti level into samashti. This is the taittiriya prakriya. Not the main prakriya, but a prakriya nonetheless. It can be reversed as well, if it is easier for one to analyze from one's own level. Because we say everything has come from Ishvara, we merge everything belonging to us into Ishvara. That is one prakriya. Mandukya takes the other way. Because the moksha ichchu is the jiva, not Ishvara. Every analysis is from the perspective of the jiva. So it is drishti srishti vada, landing into ajata vada. You look at the jiva, who you are, and then you say, I am this jiva who is a samsari. What is this prapancha that I cognize? Who is the creator? The same question is at the root of each and every prakriya. But in Mandukya, what is done in the akara, ukara, makara is taken as shariratraya. In that shariratraya also, panchakosha is included, as we saw just now in the opening. There the vyashti and samashti analysis is also done at the same time. But the samashti is resolved in the vyashti. Virat Purusha along with the stula prapancha is resolved in the Vishwa, who is the stula sharira abhimani at the vyashti level. So the entire samashti is resolved in the vyashti. And at each level, this whether you do it at the kosha level or at sharira level. And then it is resolved into the abhimani himself. So everything is resolved into Vishwa. Vishwa is resolved into Tejasa, in whom Hiranyagarbha, the samashti, stula sharira abhimani is resolved along with the stula sukshma prapancha, along with the swapna prapancha, and this abhimani at the vyashti level, taijasa, has the whole now, has the entire stula sharira and sukshma sharira resolved in him. Who is the sadhaka jiva, which is also at the stula level identified by a, the a akshara akara, akara ukara makara, at the stula sukshma and karana level, or at the three avastha levels, meaning jagrata, sapna and shushupti levels. So you can take any of these prakriyas and resolve it either way, in the samashti also and vyashti also, whichever is simpler for you, without any doubts. Of course, you should not have a doubt that, oh, how can I resolve it into vyashti? I am a small sadhaka, not even a sadhaka. So all these ideas, if they are troubling, then it is easier to merge it in Ishvara, samashti. So submissive approach. With bhakti, you can resolve it into the Lord. In the end, it will be resolved, the sukshma sharira, which is resolved at the vyashti and samashti level into the staijasa. He, along with the stula prapancha and abhimani devata, and sukshma prapancha and the abhimani devata, as well as the abhimani vishwa and taijasa, all are resolved into, either you say karana sharira or you say makara, into the prajna, who is the karana sharira abhimani, or in avasthatre viveka prakriya, the shushupti avastha abhimani. This shushupti avastha abhimani prajna at the samashti level is Ishvara. Samashti karana sharira, maya shariri. So all of that is again resolved into individual prajna. This prajna then identified this with this letter makara, As an upasana also it's possible. This makara is resolved into, so makara has akara ukara also with this tool and sukshma, prapancha and prapancha abhimani. Then the karana sharira has no division at all. There is no division seen. In Sushupti, there is no individuality at all, because all of this is resolved. So it is very clear at that level. And this anandamaya kosha level, karana sharira level, avidya or maya sharira, Ishwaras or Prajna Sharira is one and the same, finally resolved into Amatra, where Akara, Ukara, Makara also go away and there is complete silence. In that silence, which is the Atma Tattva, Chaitanya, where there is no ripple of any Bheda, any Vritti, in that the Atma, in that Pratyagatma, which is Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya, and there are no levels there. If you have to call it a level also, there is no level, that is Turiya. In that, everything is resolved. There is no Samashti Vyashti Bheda possible there. Because Samashti Vyashti Bheda is actually resolved at the Sharira level in the Sushupti Avastha itself. In Sushupti Avastha also, there is no Raja, Bhikshuka, Simha, Makshika, there are no Bhedas. Each Prani, each Devata, each Rakshasa, each individual man or woman is resolved, has resolved one's own individuality. There is no individual there at all. And in that singularity, with Ajnana of course, because that singularity is an Ajnana, my Swarupa is still veiled. There itself, the Bhedas are resolved. In Sushupti, there is no Bheda. Nobody can talk about Sushupti Bheda. Nobody can use any convincing example of Sushupti Bheda. Bhedas are only at the Sukshma and Stula level. Even at the Ajnana level, even the Sukshma Bheda is not there. Then what to talk about the Bheda at the Prajna level, at the Turiya level. Turiya, considering the three states, there is a fourth. But there is no real fourth. This is the Purna Tattva, which is pervading all the other three states, all the three Shariras, all the Pancha Koshas at the Vyashti and Samashti levels. This Atma, Pratyangatma, which is Brahma, Shuddha Brahma, Satchidananda Brahma, is the only real vastu, vasatiti vastu, that is the only real vastu, which is me, the innermost I. So that is said here as the vyapaka tattva is atma, avyapaka is anatma, and atma is nitya, everything else is anitya. So samashti panchakosha vilakshanam asti. What is that? Any of the, and you start anywhere, you can land on the Vyashti and Samashti Panchakosha Vivekabhut. Yatha Panchakosha Vilakshanam Jiva Swarupam Tatha Eva Ishwara Swarupam Api Panchakosha Vilakshanam Asti. Samashti Panchakosha Vilakshanam Asti. So Samashti Vyashti, at the Kosha levels also, the Bheda is only in the quantity, sum total versus part. But there is no other qualitative Bheda. And if you take away the Koshas, there is no quantity or qualitative Bheda. Either of the Bhedas do not exist at the Turiya level or at the Pratyangatma level, Chaitanya or Atma level. Chaturta Tarange, Chaturvidha Akasha Drishtantena, Jiveshwarayoho Laksha Swarupa Vivechanam Vistarena Uktam. Upari Shashta Tarange Api अस्थिभाति प्रिय रूप निरूपण प्रसंगे महावाक्यार्थ निरूपण प्रसंगे च आत्मनः परमार्थ स्वरूपं निरूपयिष्यते संग्रहेण अत्र आत्मविवेचनं कृतम्. सो दिस इज आत्मविवेक हियर. नॉट मच इज डन हियर बिकॉज मेनी प्रक्रियाज डू एग्जिस्ट. दिस आकाश, यू हैव सीन घटाकाश एंड देन द महाकाश एनालाइज वेरी वेल इन द चतुर्थ Taranga. In Shashta Taranga, which will follow, there also this Asti Bhati Priya and then Nama Rupa. Adhyatrayam is sat, whereas sat in the real basically, and nama rupa, the other two are mithya. This is what Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says in Panchakosha, in the Panchadashi also, in the, I think, the fourth chapter. So asti bhati priya and nama rupa, these are discussed. Or in the Dridrishya Viveka also, there may be a mention. So, asti bhati priya is Satchidananda. Other words for Satchidananda. And nama rupa is used everywhere as being anatma and mithya, explained as anatma and mithya, which we'll see a little more in the sixth chapter. Therefore, mahavakyartha nirupada prasangecha atmana paramartha swarupam nirupayishyate. However, here sangrahena atma vivechanam krutam. Mahavakyartha upadesha nirupanam. Before that, let's go to the tippana. Looks like it's quite long. Where does it start? Okay. I think we have not seen the second tippana. Pratitikatvam Vedanta Siddhante Jagata Sputam Sushuptautu Jagallinam Prabodhe Jayate Punaha Drishti Srishti Mimam Brahmanubhavi Bahumanyate Iti. So this was mentioned in the some point there, second point made there. To search where it was though. Here it is, one. Here, so sarvakare prapancha pravilaya. So tada sarvakare prapancha pravilayat. Then in sushupti, takcha sukam sushupto na vishaya janyam. So sukha is manifest in the antakkarana. There is a sukha anubhava whenever there is vishaya sambandha. This is the general understanding, whether it is in waking or in dream, there is a vishaya and vishaya janya sukha is there. In sushupti, there is no vishaya, but there is sukha. And in sushupti, whatever is there in sushupti, the aham, that I exist across the three states. When I do avastatraya viveka, panchakosha viveka, or Shariyatraya Viveka, what am I doing? I am doing Anvaya Vyatireka. Whatever has Vyabhichara, the Sharira or Kosha or anything that is there in the Avastha, if it changes across all of these, whatever changes across these, we'll look at the states. So whatever changes across the avasthas, whatever has vyabhichara is asat. Because sat is what? Trikala baditam sat. In all the three kalas, all the three avasthas also, what is common is sat. What does not change. And that is the pratyagatma. Only atma is common. I am the witness of the jagrat avastha, swapna and Sushupti avastha also. So I am common here. Ananda is not seen common. Ananda is seen in all the three states, cognized in all the three states. There is sukha anubhava. But what is this sukha due to is not known in waking and dream because of the noise of the vishayas. Vishayas drag the indriyas, and we have seen they create a want. They create more and more impressions for more and more desires, making a person more and more wanting. Thereby, the mind is filled with so much of noise of the desire towards the Vishaya, Ichha towards the Vishaya, that the person is no longer in his Swarupa. Swarupe na tishtati. Barely ever, rarely ever. And this withdrawal from one's own swarupa gives a lot of dukkha. Because sukha is one's own swarupa. Now this is as per Shruti. But if you look at Tarka also, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says elsewhere, in the Ananda Mimamsa or elsewhere also, how do you know this Ananda is one's own swarupa? In Sushupti also, how do you know it is this your own Ananda? Because Vishayas are not there. It's as simple as that. Vishayas are not there. Even then, did you have sukha or not? So we don't get confused between whether I had a particular vishaya in the dream versus in jagrat avastha. Over a period of time, maybe the differences will fade. But as soon as I wake up from the swapna and I had a good dream, let's say, I enjoyed my dream life. My waking life is miserable in comparison. I know very clearly when I wake up, I may want to dream more. But I have no choice in wanting to dream that. But I know clearly that I had sukha due to this vishaya in the dream. That vishaya is not there in the waking. Because we are looking at ananda, I am comparing only ananda, not the dukkha, sukha. So sukha in the dream object, sukha in the waking object. Now if you look at the nightmare also, dukkha also. In the dream, I had less sukha or dukkha with a particular vishaya. Whereas in waking, either I don't have that vishaya or I have no dukkha due to that vishaya. I have only sukha due to that vishaya, or that vishaya not being there, some other vishaya is giving me sukha. I know very clearly as to whether the jagrat vishaya has brought me sukha or swapna vishaya has brought me sukha. So I am comparatively wise. I can make out a difference between which vishaya gave me which sukha. That is why I crave for that vishaya. And obviously in the waking state. Or, you know, moderners say, you know, sweet dreams. Why sweet dreams? Because everyone is looking forward to a better life. If not in waking, let's say in dream itself. Let me enjoy in the dream itself. At least that much sukha there. This is a misunderstanding, but I am very clear in associating sukha with which vishaya. When I associate sukha with which vishaya I associated and which state, I am clear. Therefore, I trust myself to identify in which avastha I had sukha. That much I have to at least trust myself. And when I wake up, I know that there was no vishaya. Swapna and sthula vishaya, any sthula or any swapna vishaya in the sushupti avastha. And I know that I had sushupti avastha. I cannot say that I didn't have sushupti and say that, it's all well. If I am continuously dreaming or I am continuously in the waking state, then I am not sushupta. This is the prakriya. And these are the general terms. We are not doing deep scientific analysis. Saying this because there was a question regarding this. So in the sushupti avastha, in the deepest of the sleeps, which is the, we have to say, non-dream and non-waking state, that is sushupti. Scientifically, what happens in the brain is, we are not bothered about it. I need my deep sleep. Sushupti meaning I need ajagrata and aswapna avastha. That is sushupti. What is the sushupti avastha definition? We should not take scientific definition. Mandukya definition is what? Yatra supto na kanchana pashyati, na kanchana swapnam pashyati. Just let me recall, give me a moment. Supto na kanchana. I don't remember the earlier mantra, therefore I can't remember the later. Just give me a moment, I'll look up. Because I just want to make this avastha trayaveka to comment on this. So sushupta avastha definition in Mandukya Upanishad is, yatra suptona kanchan kamam kamayate na kanchana supnam pashyati tat sushuptam. So what is sushupta avastha? It is not a scientifically identifiable state. That is not the analysis. The analysis is yatra suptona kanchana kamam kamayate. How do you know that you had sushupti avastha on waking up? Why are we doing this analysis? Because where is the source of ananda? Ananda is the most difficult. Even the advanced sadhakas have trouble to understand and explain this Ananda Swarup of Atma. Everyone has dukkha, everyone wants Ananda. Moksha is Ananda Swarupa. So Ananda is the Paramapurushartha really. Sat is not the Paramapurushartha. Sat, Chit, Ananda. In that Chit is not Paramapurushartha. You already know that. Very easy to understand. If one has a little Viveka also, Sat and Chit are very easy to understand. But Ananda, extremely difficult. People have difficulty to claim that I am Sukhi. Without any dependency on anything else. I want this, therefore, only if I get it, I'll have sukha. There's always an association with some. This happens, this event takes place, I'll be happy. Never is a person happy. Anitya keeps on hankering endlessly. Therefore, Ananda is the real Paramapurushartha. We should not feel ashamed to say that. It is. My swartha is in Ananda. Whether it is through my shishu, my parents, my spouse, any other vishaya, all these are outward identifications where I am searching for that sukha which keeps on slipping. If someone tells you that, you know, Ananda, moksha is not that kind of Ananda, experiential Ananda, fine. But is it Ananda Swarupa or not? If you tell a person that give up everything, you will get moksha. What kind of moksha? Dukkha Swarupa. Who wants it? You will get everything that you want in your life except for sukha. Who wants that moksha? Nobody. Nobody will even pursue, take the first step. So it is said that the Shruti says Ananda Swarupa is moksha. But it is a fact. It is not that Shruti tells you something and then tricks you. Then you see that moksha is Dukkha Swarupa. There are people who have made this statement. I wanted this and I got it, but now there is a lot of dukkha. These are the people who are searching for Ananda and have not landed on Ananda because it is misunderstood. Vairagya is still not complete. There is hankering after something which is Vaishayika Sukha. That kind of Ananda is not there because they are still looking at that experience which they have got and want to multiply it literally. That is not going to happen. I don't know whether you have heard of U.G. Krishnamurti. So U.G. Krishnamurti is one of them who said that, you know, I wanted it. Now that I got it, that it is very painful. Because all these associations are, you know, by force, by hatha, you try to get something. You can't hold on to that. It starts manifesting in bodily pain also. Hatha yoga. Anyway, that's an aside. What is the definition of Shushupti now? Shushupta avastha is what? That where yatra supto. So, where one is trying to sleep, we'll just say trying to sleep, gets away from the world and tries to go away from the world and just lies down, let's say. Yatra supto na kanchana kamam kamayate. Does not desire anything. Do you desire something in the sapna or in the jagradavastha? Yes. In jagradavastha, I am always hankering, be it dharma. I don't want to say that it is adharma. Dharma, I want punya, let's say. So I am hankering after punya at least. Simplest of the options you take, which is more convincing. In swapna, what am I doing? Whatever I couldn't do in waking or I couldn't do enough in waking, I am trying to mimic that in swapna avastha. So there also kama is there. Now yatra supto na kanchana kamam kamayate na kanchan. Na kanchana swapnam pashyati tat shushuptam. Swapna also, you are not dreaming. Do you have that state at all? Yes. The kids have more of such sleep state. They have more deep sleep. And in old age also, a person goes more into deep sleep. Now, of course, deceased and there may be some trouble and one cannot sleep is a different matter. But Shushupta Avastha is there. Without the Shushupti Avastha, even scientifically, a person will not survive. There will be so much of strain on the Indriyas, so much of strain on the Sharira, that a person will not survive. So, even if you take that in logic, consider that, you know that. Why? Because the person is alive. Because the person is alive, there has to be Sushupti Avastha. Absolutely no question about it. There is nothing like zero Sushupti Avastha. If it is there, the person will not survive. Scientifically also, in my understanding, a person cannot survive without Sushupti Avastha. But if you let aside science and see what is our prakriya here. Avastha Traya Prakriya is suggested by Shruti. Shruti defines this. We go by Shruti definition without overloading the words. So Sushupti Avastha, Swapna Avastha, Jagrat Avastha, all three avasthas are there for all pranis, including, yes, for animals also. Animals have Swapna also. Not only Sushupti, Swapna also. Shruti talks, how do you know? Shruti talks about it. We have Shraddha. Or Purana Kathas, you know, you see there as well, which are expressions of the same Shruti. Scientifically, I do not know how much analysis has been done by who all in pranis, but I am sure there is, because every, you know, vaccine also, when it is created, is tested on animals. So there are at least some mammals where they must have analyzed. There is REM sleep and stuff like that. They have Sushupti Avastha. We see that the even a donkey sleeps. A donkey may be sleeping standing. I've heard that a donkey sleeps while standing. Those differences may be there, but there is Sushupti Avastha, there is Swapna as well, and Jagrat we anyway know. So the definition of Sushupti is Aswapna and Ajagrata, where there is no Kama, one does not have na kanchana kamam kama. It means Kama is Kamyati iti Kama, there because Kamyate Karma is Kama. So where one does not have any desire for an object, this is a stula object now. And nas kanchana swapnam pasyati tatshutam sushupta sthane eki bhuta. Then the mantra says sushupta sthane eki bhuta prajnyaragana evanandamayo hyanandamuk cheto mukav prajnya sthiti of padha. That third pada is where in the sushupta sthana eki bhuta has become one. Vyashti samashti differences aren't there. Prajnana ghanaha, one homogeneous consciousness exists there, but veiled. But here prajnana ghana, where the stool and sukshma objects have become indifferentiable, that is the prajnana ghana there. And then eva ananda mayaha, mayat here is not in the vikara artha. Even if it is there, it is in the kosha level. Anandamaya kosha will have anandamaya has been said. If you take it as vikara artha, then it will become anandamaya kosha is the ananda vikara, swarupa ananda vikara, which cannot undergo any vikara, but then there is a gradation, so to say. What is that gradation? Free from the gradations of the stool and sukshma visheyajanya diversions or noise, that kind of ananda is there. But it is still a great different because there is avarana on the swarupa due to ajnana continuing. But how do you know that it is anandamaya, which is manifest ananda? He ananda bhuk. Ananda bhuk. Anandam bhungte. Anandam bhungte iti ananda bhuk. This prajna is ananda bhuk. Has ananda bhojana, ananda bhoga, bhojana is bhoga, bhavelut. So this prajnaha, and then cheto mukaha, he is not, this prajna is not focused outward. This atma identified with karana sharira ajnana is no longer focused outward towards swapna and jagrat. Avasthas, why so? Not identified with stula or sukshma sharira. Why so? Because na kanchana kamam kamayate, na kanchana swapnam pashyati. Tuned inward, therefore cheto mukha. Focus inward towards chetana, but still covered. That is the ananda. So ananda is established through tarka as well as shruti. So both establish the ananda in sushupti. एंड देन दिस इज इक्वल टू विद एष सर्वेश्वर एष सर्वज्ञ एष अंतर्यामी एष योनि सर्वस्य प्रभवाप्यय ही भूतानाम. एनीवे अवर गोल इज हियर इज इन द आनंदमय कोश वेर आनंद इज मैनिफेस्ट इन सुषुप्ति अवस्था. देयर बाय इट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड थ्रू श्रुति एंड न्याय प्रमाण दैट इन सुषुप्ति आनंद इज देयर. दैट इज सेड हियर एज तथा सुषुप्तौ सूक्ष्म शरीरस्य ज्ञानं न भवति सुखस्वरूप आत्मा स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूपेण प्रतीयते. सॉरी आई लॉस्ट दैट दिस थिंग सो आई वेंट बैक. सॉरी आई वेंट बैक देयर लुकिंग एट दी टिप्पण राइट या सो सुषुप्तौ तु जगल्लीनं प्रबोधे जायते पुनः दृष्टि सृष्टि इमां ब्रह्मानुभवी बहुमन्यते. एनी नॉट मच हियर दिस वाज फ्रॉम दी सेकंड हियर सर्वकार्य प्रपंच प्रविलयात. It expanded there as Pratitikattvam Vedanta Siddhante Jagata Sputam. In the waking state, it is very clear. Sushuptautu Jagallinam. That Jagat isn't there in Sushupti Avastha. Prabodhe Jayate Punaha. Comes up in waking. For whom? For the Jiva, it is seen. So whoever is the Jiva who is witnessing this Prapancha, for him the Prapancha is there. Jayate Punaha Jagat Yallinam. Jagat Tadeva Punaha Jayate when prabodhe in the way, on waking up. This is drishti srishti vada. When I see, there is jagat. When I do not see, there is no jagat. And seeing is upalakshana. If I hear, there is jagat. Shabda prapancha exists when I hear. When do I hear? Either I hear in the waking state or in the dream state, but I do not hear in the sushupti avastha. Therefore drishti srishti vam brahmanubhavi bahumanyate. This Drishti Srishti Vada is favorable. Vivarana is Drishti Srishti Vada, also called as Eka Jiva Vada. Although there is a Matabheda there. Still, it is the simplest approach because it is focused towards the Jiva who wants Moksha and everything is from his perspective. Stula Deha Vivechanam. We'll look at this later. I wanted to expound this because there was a question and this question has come up on multiple fora and by many people and it keeps on coming up again and again. Hopefully, I mean, what I said today may be helpful for some, I do not know. But then, it's a very, very interesting prakriya. Avasthatraya Viveka is very beneficial because every bit of that is based on Anubhava. If you set aside all notions and just analyze your Anubhava, set aside science, set aside everything else, not even because Shruti says, because Shruti is using Avasthatraya Prakriya because Panchakosha Viveka one may not be able to make easily. Shariratraya also, it is very sukshma. Avasthatraya should be the simplest. Why? Because it is in your Anubhava. Even a child has the Anubhava of all three Avasthas. So you won't find a simpler Prakriya to work with, simpler Prakriya to do Upasana on, and simpler prakriya to land on Aikya also. You'll have to definitely fall back in Shruti. Everything is based in Shruti. But still, Anubhava and Tarka also will have a place in Avasthatraya Viveka in the manner that we saw today. And we'll look at the Panchakosha Viveka further in more granularity. सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूपी अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर दृक्यत्व निरुपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्तो इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस? नो क्वेश्चंस. सी नेक्स्ट पार्ट. नमस्ते.
नमस्ते. हरिओम.
हरिओम.